Friday, November 5th, and with one quarter of the year behind us, we are quickly moving into the holiday season. I'm Taryn Hostetter, back with Ella Andrews.
Yes, it's been an exciting first quarter, and for the field hockey team, they won their playoff game against Littlestown at Palmyra on Wednesday. With that win, they'll play Susquehanna Township tomorrow at Lower Dolphin Middle School at 1 p.m. The winning team qualifies for states, and the losing team will wrap up its season. We talked to a few players to get their outlooks for the game tomorrow.
Tomorrow at 1, we play the 8th seed, and we are the 6th seed, so I think we have a really good chance of winning because yesterday we beat the 7th seed, and if we beat the 7th seed, I think we can beat the 8th seed as well.
So tomorrow we have a game against Susquehanna Township at Lower Dolphin, and we have a good chance of winning because on Wednesday, our goalie that normally doesn't play had an amazing game for us, and our defense really helped her out, so you should come support us at Lower Dolphin at 1.
On Wednesday, we played a really hard game. We didn't give up, and we kept going all the way through a double overtime and into a shootout. So that was really amazing. And tomorrow, we're going to do just as hard and play just as hard as we did on Wednesday.
I was at the game on Wednesday, and I was very impressed with Ava Wentling. It was her first varsity start, and she made many great saves. And if she's there on Saturday, I have very much confidence in them.
I'm not sure how many Dutchmen were able to get to their game, but those who did hopefully used the Dutchmen app in order to get points to rise to the leaderboard. If you haven't downloaded the app yet, George Yados took this opportunity to explain to you how to do it and what you can earn through using it.
2 years ago, Mr. Long launched an app that would help students stay updated on the events going on in the school and win some prizes. But unfortunately, due to COVID last year, all the events got canceled, and Mr. Long is very excited this year to have events and have people there again so we can use the app.
Yeah, we couldn't use the app last year because we couldn't have spectators coming to events. So when we looked at the year before, it was something that was popular with students and even parents. So it's something we wanted to bring back this year now that we're allowing spectators and students to come back to the athletic and different events we'll have during the school year.
We hope that the sheer amount of advantages you get from downloading the app make you ask yourself why you haven't downloaded it yet. Some of those advantages could be the information about the school events and how easily accessible it is, the calendar with most of the events, or the awards you can win by just going to the events.
If you download the app, you have an access to all the different schedules, so all the athletic events that we have participating in there. We also allow the club advisors and different people to ask to put different events on the app throughout the year that we add in there, and then give points for coming to different things like the musical, the fall play, art club did some things in the past. So you have access to all those different events. There's also a fan cam on there, so you can take pictures at those events and then upload them into the app. There's like a leaderboard, so you can track to see who's in first place and some different things. You can get the daily announcements on the app. They're posted there every day. So it has a bunch of different features for anyone who downloads it.
We also have awards available for the taking because it doesn't seem like anyone is really trying to win them at the moment. These awards include gift cards and AC gear. If you would like to have a chance to win these awards, download the app on Google Play or the App Store.
I won a sweatshirt and shorts, and it was super easy. All I had to go to were a few games here and there and support my friends. I got free clothing.
We started out again with some Dutchman AC gear. We got a bunch of that last year that we weren't able to give out, so we have a bunch of sweatshirts and t-shirts and different apparel. As we go through the year and we have different events, we're going to try to look for some gift cards and different things like that to provide as possible incentives and rewards for anybody who attends the events and checks in, or, you know, different games. So sometimes anybody who checks in a game, we'll do randomly select someone. Sometimes we'll give it to the leader like we did with Jared earlier in the year. So we're going to try to do different things to mix it up so everybody can sort of participate or at least be in a drawing to win.
Using the app is a really easy way to stay involved in school events, show your school spirit, and maybe win that hoodie you've had your eye on. I'm George Gatos from ACDN-TV.
Congratulations to Brayton Peters for winning the District 3 Cross Country Class A race last Saturday. Brayton becomes a back-to-back district champion. Cassie Clemson finished the race in third, while Nori Mitchell finished in eighth, to both earn individual medals as well. We also send congratulations to the girls' cross country team for winning the District 3 Cross Country Class A team championship on Saturday. The team includes Brayton Peters, Cassie Clemson, Nori Mitchell, Emily Manwiller, Emily Mag, Emily Stefanchik, and Nadia Lezon. All the girls will race in the PIAA Class A Championship in Hershey tomorrow at 9:30 a.m.
That's a lot of Emily's.
Yeah.
Also, congratulations to Jamar Gonzalez-Ali and Landon Hostetter for earning individual medals in the District 3 Cross Country AA race on Saturday. Jamar placed 14th while Landon placed 19th. Both boys will race tomorrow at 12:30 p.m. We talked to a few of the runners to get their outlooks for tomorrow.
So tomorrow I'm planning on just going out and having a lot of fun with the team and trying my best. And then the season has gone really well. The girls won district, so we were really excited about that. And we're really excited to see what next year holds then.
So my prospects for tomorrow is basically just keeping a positive mindset and encouraging my team to do better. And the season as a whole is a lot of team bonding experiences where we just tried to keep a whole positive mindset the whole time and work towards our goal. And yeah, I'm excited for it and I think we're gonna do great.
So overall, I think our team did pretty well. We made it all the way to districts and got some runners to states, and hopefully we'll be able to run competitively tomorrow. We're hoping for some good times. We got some good competition.
I'm super excited for states tomorrow. We came off a strong district run. We were able to claim district champions as a team, which is awesome. And I was able to be back-to-back district champion, which is super fun. So tomorrow we are looking forward to a good race, back to normal with everybody going all out at once and not split up into groups like last year. So it'll be nice to have a normal year for my last one as a senior. And this season we had been doing very well, progressing each race and taking everything one step at a time as goal is states.
Good luck, runners. The high school mini-thon committee will meet Tuesday at 2:20 in Mr. Coleman's room to discuss the craft show for next Saturday. For ACDN-TV, I'm Ella Andrews.
And I'm Taryn Hostetter. Have a wonderful weekend, AC.